Professor Tyndale, thank you so much for joining us at the conference. We appreciate very much the comments that you've made at the conference. Could you tell us just how variations in genetic background influence whether or not somebody's likely to be a smoker?
Sure. So the specific aspects that we've been looking at are the rate of nicotine inactivation. So some people metabolize nicotine very quickly and some people metabolize it very slowly. And this results in different smoking behaviors, levels of smoking, levels of dependence. But it also affects how they respond to the different treatment drugs that we have.
So this knowledge could have implications as to how we help individuals who are smokers stop smoking.
Sure. So at the moment, we tend to treat all smokers as one group. And what we're hoping is that we can identify small subgroups who respond better to one treatment or to another treatment, whether that's a behavioral counseling or varenicline or one of the different options that we have.
And do you have any signals at this point that you can share?
Sure. I'm going to be talking about some of the differences in both, again, as I mentioned, the rates of nicotine metabolism, but also the rates of bupropion metabolism Wellbutrin or Zyban. And other people in collaboration with us also look at differences in nicotinic receptors, which is where nicotine binds in the brain.
Are there any ways in which, apart from a sophisticated genetic analysis or measuring rates of nicotine metabolism, that one can pick up cues from smokers or non-smokers as to whether they're likely to have difficulty stopping smoking or it's likely to become addicted with ease?
Sure. So I think that there are some various phenotypes or behaviors that we could look for, which are telltale signs of higher dependence or more rapid escalations in smoking. Some of the ones that we tend to look at are the time to the very first cigarette in the morning as one, for example. And those can also help us think about how to tailor treatment as well.
Well, let me, in closing, just thank you very much for the work that you do, the impact that it has, and for joining us here in Ottawa today.